Hello my dear students, I welcome you all to the next subtopic of oscillation chapter. And in this subtopic we are going to learn about the angular SHM and its differential equation. So just like we studied for linear SHM and its differential equation, so what was linear SHM? Just to revise, linear SHM, it was nothing but the definition where restoring force is always directed towards the mean position, and it was directly proportional to the displacement. So the direction wise, the formula was F, it is directly proportional to minus of x. Now, what was the differential equation? Its differential equation was d square x divided by dt square plus omega square x. This value is equal to zero. Now, same thing, it could be angular SHM. So just to move from linear motion to curvilinear motion, so there are some analogous quantities. The force analogous quantity is torque. So in this case, this was the restoring force. This will be called as restoring torque. This will be restoring torque. This you have studied in rotational dynamics, the analogous quantities. This is directly proportional to x. So this is minus of x, analogous quantity is theta, the angular displacement. So this is the angular displacement. And similarly, the formula for differential equations we will get for the angular SHM. Okay, so this is all about the introduction to the angular SHM. So in linear SHM, the particle was moving like this. In a straight line, but in angular SHM, it will moving in the curve, like clockwise, then anti-clockwise, then again clockwise, anti-clockwise, like this. Okay. So let us see what is the definition of angular SHM. So explain angular SHM. What is angular SHM? Angular SHM is defined as the oscillatory motion of a body in which the torque for angular acceleration is directly proportional to the angular displacement and its direction is opposite to that of the angular displacement. So angular SHM is defined as the oscillatory motion of the body in which the torque for angular acceleration, so torque means tau, is directly proportional to, so it is directly proportional to the angular displacement. Angular displacement is theta. And its direction is opposite to that of the angular displacement. That means tau is directly proportional to minus of theta. So this as per the definition of angular SHM, we are getting this. Tau is directly proportional to minus of theta. So tau will be equal to, I will introduce a constant of proportionality, which is C, and this is what theta. So C is the constant of proportionality. This is called as a restoring torque constant. Okay, restoring torque constant, or this is also called as torsional constant. Torsional constant. So the same thing that we have studied in the 11th standard, the universal gravitation constant concept, that C was the torsional constant there. Okay. So these are the names of this C. So what is C? C can be written like this. So tau divided by theta. So if you remove the negative sign, you don't consider a direction. So what C is it is the restoring torque acting per unit angular displacement. So what it is? Restoring torque acting per unit angular displacement. So this is actually the torsional constant definition. Okay. So this is all about the angular SHM. Now let us move to the example of angular SHM, how this angular SHM it will look like. So this is the supposed metallic disc. So this metallic disc, it is attached to the string. Suppose it is rotated in this way. So there will be a torque acting on this string. So this string, it is just a fixed string. So because of the restoring torque, it will move in opposite direction. Because of the restoring torque, it will move in the opposite direction. So it will first move in anti-clockwise, then it will move in clockwise, again it will move in anti-clockwise, then again it will move in clockwise, such that this point, it will perform angular SHM. This point will be performing angular SHM. So what is this arrangement? The figure shows the metallic test. It is attached centrally to a thin wire. Preferably, the wire will be nylon or any other metallic wire, hanging from the rigid support. If the disc is slightly twisted about the axis along the wire and released, so it performs rotational motion partly in clockwise and anti-clockwise. Or anti-clockwise means opposite sense. The another name of anti-clockwise is counterclockwise. Such oscillations, they are called as angular oscillations, or I can say torsional oscillations. Okay, so this is just an example of how this angular SHM can happen. Let us now understand the differential equation of SHM, angular SHM. Differential equation of angular SHM. So here we say that as per the definition of angular SHM, the tau, it is equal to minus c into theta. Now only we have seen this tau, it is equal to minus c into theta. From rotational motion, concept, what is the value of tau? Tau, it is equal to I into alpha. Tau, it is equal to, so this formula you have learned in the rotational dynamics chapter. Tau, it is equal to I into alpha, where I, it is equal to moment of inertia of rotating body, and alpha, it is called as angular acceleration. Alpha, it is called as angular acceleration. So you can substitute the value in this formula. So I can say this is suppose equation number 1, this is suppose equation number 2. So from 1 and 2, you can say, from 1 and 2, you can say that tau and tau both are same. LHS are equal, RHS will be equal. So therefore, I alpha, it is equal to minus of C into theta. Okay, I alpha, it is equal to minus of C into theta. So therefore, what is the value of alpha? Alpha, it is equal to minus C divided by I into theta. So see here, since C and I are constant, so therefore I can write alpha, it is directly proportional to minus of theta. What was the formula of A in linear SHM? A was equal to minus omega square x. Omega was constant, A was directly proportional to minus x. So see, this is again the analogous quantity. A analogous quantity is what? Alpha. X analogous quantity is what? Theta. So that means alpha, it is directly proportional to, alpha, it is directly proportional to minus of theta, right? Alpha, it is directly proportional to minus of theta. So this is the property of angular SHM. This is the property of angular SHM. Okay. Alpha, it is directly proportional to minus of theta. So here I can say this, I can again consider this formula. Alpha, it is nothing but the rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time. Angular acceleration is defined as, so I can write, we know that alpha, it is equal to alpha, which is nothing but angular acceleration, is defined as rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time. And what about angular velocity? It is nothing but rate of change of angular displacement with respect to time. So that means this is equal to d square theta divided by dt square. So here, since alpha it is equal to minus c divided by I into theta, I can say this is d square theta divided by dt square. The value of alpha, it is d square theta divided by dt square, it is equal to minus c divided by I into theta, such that you can write the formula like this: d square theta divided by dt square, minus will come here, this will become plus c divided by I into theta, and this value it is equal to 0. This value is equal to 0. Okay, so this is what the second order differential equation for particle forming angular SHF. This is second order differential equation for particle performing angular SHF. Okay, so this is all about the topic of angular SHF. So what about the time period? The time period there in linear SHM, the time period was given by the value of t. T it is equal to 2 pi under root of a by x in the case of linear SHM. But now in the case of angular SHM, this was for linear SHM. Now in the case of angular SHM, t will be equal to 2 pi. The analogous quantity of a it is alpha, while the analogous quantity of x is theta. This is for angular SHF. Okay, so this is the note point. All of you please pause the video. You please write this derivation. This completes our subtopic angular SHF. The next subtopic that we are going to learn is the magnet vibrating in uniform magnetic field. Thank you so much all of you for your time and attention. Goodbye, take care.